In today's video, I want to run you guys through a pretty random but awesome PlayStation 4 game sale that Amazon is running right now. Target just launched their buy one get one 50% off sale, but Amazon actually rose the ante a little bit. They're running their own buy one get one 50% off, but they're also including a bunch of games that are pre-order titles. Final Fantasy VII Remake is in there, Catherine Full Body is in there, and a bunch of other games are also being included. Now, the selection isn't as vast as, say, Target's lineup, however, I would say that each individual deal and each individual game that is available, from that standpoint, it is a little bit stronger. So we'll take a look at that. And also, I want to highlight to you guys a new action strategy game that has been announced for the PlayStation 4, and that is Lorne Sword Winter. That is coming to the PlayStation 4, and that will be coming sometime in October. And a new Need for Speed title will be announced very, very soon, in just a few days. Electronic Arts has launched a teaser website counting down to the announcement, so we'll talk that. And I imagine we're gonna see a lot of gameplay coming out of Gamescom as well, so we'll talk that at the end of this video. First up, I really want to highlight this buy one, get one 50% off that Amazon is running right now. Remember that you get 50% off on the lesser priced item, so you don't want to pair, say, a $60 game with a $20 game, because that means you're just saving $10. You would ideally want to pair a $60 game with another $60 game, so you're going to save a full $30. $40 game with a $40 game, you get the idea. At the very least, try to get the games to be as close in price as possible. A lot of the deals, we do see some resemblance to what Target is running, but I know a lot of you guys have Amazon Prime, or you would just prefer not to shop out of Target. Whatever the case may be, Amazon is definitely the go-to online shop as opposed to Target.com. I don't think it's too much of a far cry to say that. Let's go over some of the deals that are available that will seem a little bit resemblant. Days Gone is down to $38. I think pairing that with Resident Evil 2 or Devil May Cry 5 is the best route to go. That will offer you a significant savings. Mortal Kombat 11 is also in there, and I think the best game to pair that up with is Sekiro Shadows Die Twice. Those are right around the same price, Mortal Kombat 11 being at $49, Sekiro is at $48. And given that both of those games have definitely held up in price, wouldn't it be a bad idea to pick both of those up if you have yet to? I also see Tales of Vesperia Definitive Edition, that is down to $30. Hitman 2 is also down to $30, so pairing those two up wouldn't be all too bad. Nickelodeon Kart Racers is available for $30. That's a pretty recent release, so that's something I wanted to know. Jump Force is down to $40. You've got some cheaper games in there like Bloodborne, which is $19. Final Fantasy 15 is available for $20. Batman Arkham Knight is available for $15. To go back to the $30 tier, Hellblade: Senua's Sacrifice is available for that price. Dark Souls Remastered is available for $30 as well, and I would say that's pretty good. Dark Souls Remastered has held up in price. The Dark Souls games generally do, but nonetheless, for that to be down to $30, that is really good. However, the best thing about Amazon sale is that a lot of pre-orderable games are also included. I see the Final Fantasy VII Remake Deluxe Edition included, Catherine Full Body Premium Edition is also included. Those are $80 a pop, so you could get both of those, save $40. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like the FF7 Standard Edition or the Catherine Full Body Standard Edition are a part of this sale. Elden Ring is available to pre-order, that is $60, and Tales of Arise is $60, so you can get both of those and save 50% off on one of them. Essentially, you're getting each game for $45, because think of it this way, you're paying $60 for Elden Ring, and then you save 50% off on Tales of Arise. Add those two price points together, that's $90, divide by two, that means $45 a pop. I also see Sword Art Online as Civilization Licorice. That is, of course, the Sword Art Online RPG that is going to take you through the actual story of SAO. Biomune, the new IP from THQ Nordic and being developed by Experiment 101, that is listed as a part of this sale. It is $60, of course. Pair that with a game like Elden Ring and you'll get both of them for $45. That is really great. Also, if you want another game to pair with the $60 title, Shadow of the Tomb Raider, the Croft Edition, is available for $60. I wouldn't pay $60 for SOTR at this point, but nonetheless, if you want the cool steelbook and all of those extras, I guess that's not horrible. But at this point, SOTR is like a year old. The base game is going for relatively cheap, but just thought I'd mention that as well. Outside of that, I didn't even mention Kingdom Come Deliverance Royal Edition, which is listed for $37. Hey, pair that with Days Gone or pair that with Devil May Cry 5, and that is a great deal. KCD is an awesome game, and the Royal Edition includes all of the DLC, and that is a great buy if you do pair it with the right game. Again, with KCD, I would pair it with a game like Devil May Cry 5, Resident Evil 2, or Days Gone. That's how you're going to get the best deal possible. Look at the lineup for yourself and pair together the games just according to price points. Remember, just don't pair a $60 game with a $20 game. Hell, don't pair a $60 game with a $40 game if you want the most amount of savings possible, because you want that lesser price game to be as high priced as possible without being more expensive, of course. to save the most amount of money possible. It's pretty easy to follow through. However, a sale like this that is a buy one, get one 50% off, I see some people do stupid things, again, like pairing a $50 game with a $20 game, and then you're completely destroying the point of a sale like this. If you pair games accordingly, you can actually end up getting really good deals, so check that out. I'll leave a link in the description box below. All right, moving on from that, the action strategy game in Lorn Sword Winter Chronicle is coming to the PlayStation 4 this October. Lorn Sword Winter Chronicle first launched on PC via Steam Early Access all the way back in May of this year, and it's a story-driven action strategy game. Be the general on a battlefield and take direct action to command your soldiers and set up your economy. The Lorn Empire counts on you to keep your mind pure and your Lorn Sword sharp. The game was released at $18.99 and hardly anyone checked it out. There are 4 Steam user reviews. Yes, a total of 4 user reviews, but all of them are very positive and they say very good things about the game. So even at an early access standpoint, it seems like the game is rather good. I really dig the visual style in this one, and it could be one that surprises a lot of people. It notes, control your hero directly, fight, lead, explore, capture, summon, execute your tactics in a heartbeat. Strategy through planning, set up your army over time, manage gold, food, battle fronts, unit types, building upgrades, organize your global strategy on several fronts, orienting your economy and relying on your troops' intelligence to execute your orders. Follow the Chronicle of the Lorn Empire. You are Khorne Lan-Ka, and the Winter Chronicle is seen through your eyes, the eyes of a Lorn Knight serving the Empire and destined to see much more than that. Choose your difficulty through the story. The Winter Chronicle is told through chapters. Each of them lets you choose which battle you want to wage next and what level of challenge you seek. If a specific battle is too hard, try it on another difficulty setting. If you really don't like that, then skip it altogether. Each chapter can be won without winning all of its battles. That's pretty good, especially for someone like me, where I do find strategy games to be a little bit more difficult because it's not really my genre of choice. But nonetheless, it looks like this one offers a lot in terms of adjusting the difficulty settings and even skipping content altogether to progress through the story and the chapters. So that's really cool. Again, the game will be dropping in October. Hopefully, as we get closer to the release, there's a little bit of steam picked up for it, because by the people that did play the game, it seemed to be received rather well. However, just not enough people have checked it out. Hopefully that changes with the release of the game on consoles. And lastly, while EA didn't have a traditional E3 press conference, it looks like they will be making their presence felt at Gamescom. And one new title that I expect to see there is a brand new Need for Speed title, and it was just confirmed that the game will be officially announced on August 14th. Electronic Arts has launched a teaser website counting down to the announcement of the next Need for Speed title. The countdown will end on August 14th at 7 a.m. Pacific time, 10 a.m. Eastern. Back in May, Electronic Arts confirmed that a new Need for Speed is due out later in 2019. So yes, they're announcing the game in just a few days, and the game is going to turn around and be launched probably in November, I would imagine. We don't really have a lot of major games being released in November, and it would be kind of insane if a AAA game like Need for Speed is announced and then it's just released 2 months later. I mean, that wouldn't be all too shocking. You don't really have to promote a game like this too hard. Need for Speed kind of sells on its name brand at this point, although I do want a quality game, because the last few Need for Speed games have left a lot to be desired, with Need for Speed Payback, Need for Speed 2015, I believe. I really enjoyed Need for Speed Rivals, and I thought that was a pretty good game, but we're talking a PlayStation 4 launch game with that one. If this Need for Speed game is underwhelming, that would be really detrimental to the franchise. We need a quality NFS title, and NFS has been one of the most inconsistent series in recent memories. There have been good Need for Speed games. Again, I point to Rivals, I point to Need for Speed Hot Pursuit, but in recent memory it just hasn't been very good, so hopefully this one can turn the tide a little bit. And that's gonna conclude this video. Again, check out Amazon's awesome buy one get one 50% off sale right now. A lot of pre-order titles, whether it be FF7 Remake, the Deluxe Edition, Catherine Full Body, Tales of Arise, Elden Ring, Biomutant, a lot of good games are featured as a part of that, so do take advantage of it. And Lorn Sword Winter, while not many people are playing it as it is a Steam Early Access game, the people that have seemed to like it quite a bit, and I think making the transition to the PlayStation 4, maybe getting a little bit more recognition in the gaming media, it might turn out to be one of the sleeper hits later this year. So hopefully it turns out pretty well, because reading about the game, it does sound like a pretty compelling strategy game and a strategy title that could be up my and many other gamers' alley. And a new Need for Speed game will be announced on August 14th. That concludes this video. Sound off with all of your thoughts in the comment section down below. Thank you for watching and goodbye. Hey guys, we hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, make sure to hit the subscribe button, and if you're already subscribed, do us a favor and hit the bell icon. This way you'll be notified whenever we post a new video. That's the best way to keep up with all of our uploads, and we usually try to upload 2 videos a day. And with the bell icon hit, you'll be notified whenever we do upload a video. As always, thanks for watching.